Ankit Bhargava is an open street map enthusiastic, and he's part of like sensing local team, focusing on making cities healthier and more inclusive. So he's here to speak about how they have worked and making it as a navigation map of Cubbon Park.
I'm an urban planner, and I'm part of Sensing Local. And the reason why we wanted to do this was that we face a crisis as well, that in trying to solve urban problems, the biggest sort of gap is data. And without workable, usable public data, you cannot solve the very hard pressing problems that we see. And what we're seeing right now is that a lot of the public data is not becoming available because government is not opening it up. And the silos of private data are only becoming bigger. And so how do you sort of bridge these two gaps? Because none of them are willing to sort of pour the data into one common place. So the proposition here is that people like us sit in the middle of that. So we are practitioners that are making projects on ground. And because of the lack of data on one side and sort of hacking and stealing data on the other side, we tend to create our own data. What I have here is a project where OSM was a huge enabler for making this project sort of come to fruition. At the same time, it wasn't enough to really pull it through to the entire project. And so I want to show you about what OSM gave us and what enabled, but also all the stuff that we did on the other on the side, and we had to do on the side to actually build this map up. So this is part of a wayfinding and legibility sort of system in which has come up in Cubbon Park. So I'm just going to run through that. The one thing that I do want to say is that maps, the reason why we did this project was not just because Cubbon Park required wayfinding as a system in there, but because maps are a way of sort of saying what is the future of the park. So unless we can see it, unless we understand it, we cannot imagine what the next step should be. So this is where we began. And these are what we did was we just documented all the layers that we have been accumulating throughout the project. So what you see is what we started from. And these were the seven steps that we had. So the first layer of OSM became the first thing that we started the brief with. So this is what we used to make the proposition to the tourism department to say there is a need for this. What is the dimensions of Cubbon Park? What does it abut? What are the districts? What are the landmarks? What are the things that we need to deal with? And OSM was great help because other people had put data on it that we could use. And that was the first level sort of strategy for the wayfinding project itself. That helped us create the first public map, which was there for a year inside Cubbon Park Metro. And this was used to then get public inputs, to open this up for public participation, essentially. Because otherwise, this project could have been done in a silo and would have been a big mess. So this sort of allowed everyone to come and say, OK, what do I see in the park? What is my landmark in the park? And what are the kind of discoveries that have otherwise not been acknowledged? So these were all the sort of snapshots, all the post-its that people put up, they wrote on the map, did all kinds of things. And this got digested and became the new landmarks that the map should have, that people associate with, the kind of activities that people were doing that remained unacknowledged. This is one of the rare parks that's open throughout the day. This is the second most important sort of layer after that we got. This is a survey drawing that was given to us by the Horticulture Department. If you try and ask them for it, you'll never get it. It only becomes available because it is a government project. And this is a survey that was done a couple of years ago, and we got the exact boundaries of the park, which have otherwise remained a big mystery. The OSM boundaries were not correct in this case, so we had to sort of change them. As well as the fact that we had a tree survey. There are 6,000 trees that they were surveyed, but the OSM doesn't have it. And a couple of other things like the water flows and then the fountains and boulders, et cetera. On top of that, we also did field mapping by ourselves. So we used all kinds of applications that are there to do benches in Cubbon Park. There are like 1,000 benches or so. The pathways, the inner pathways, the walkways within the gardens itself, as well as all the dots that you can see, that are the bridges, the routes, all of that was done through field mapping. All the yellows that you can see is basically the stuff that I'm adding on. Then there were sort of discussions with experts that were giving us advice on trees that are there or historic sites that are there, that the information that's never present, but a map should have it, because if you don't know it, then you don't know if it's historically important. So this is all the other stuff that was done. We also conducted 6 walks where people went around and pointed at stuff that was important, whether it was heritage trees or it was some flora fauna that was great to sort of map. And this also had a blind person that actually came in and said, okay, what is my perception of space? So from here, there's a braille map also popping out. Then we also went into this prototype stage where we were trying to understand orientation. How do people read the space? It's not the north, right? No one in your head sort of thinks north. you imagine the space as you are there. Again, it went to a second level of prototyping where, again, people gave us inputs on, okay, what is the readability of that? Are we communicating what people are thinking? And lastly, we came up with this map. It's a lot darker on the screen. But you can see the amount of layers that sort of got added up from about 7 to 9 to around 34 to 38. And the two maps, the couple of maps that are there in Cubbon Park, which you can go see, but these are the dominant ones which we absorbed. And what I want to end the presentation with is actually two screenshots of the OSM and what we produced. And we added a lot more layers to ours, including bloom cycles of things and clusters of trees, avenues, statues that were not there, activities, even in some cases, tree crowns. In this case, these are the real trees that actually been there in the survey. And so this is the kind of production that is available. Why we are here is that we have used open data all this while, and we've never said thank you to the people who made it. What I'm actually trying to say here is that we are the next contributors to it. We sit in the middle, and so we want to see how we can move from the consumers of yesterday to the contributors of tomorrow. And we don't know enough about OSM, we don't know about the ecosystem. But there's a lot that we can give us, so the practitioners in the room need to become the next enablers. So that's all I have to present. You can go enjoy the signage in Cubbon Park.